this is a critical time for funding education here in Pennsylvania. We're going to talk about that with State Representative Marc Gergely. And Representative, you have been passionate in your support of trying to raise money for the Duquesne School District. What's happening?
Oh, Kevin, it is still a passion of mine to fight for these kids. I've lived this situation as an elected official since 2002 when I first stepped into the role of state representative, and it's more dire now than it ever has been. The cuts from even the new proposed Republican budget that's in the state Senate as we speak are so bad that, in my opinion, there's not enough money to even open the doors of Duquesne to educate one child. The appropriation, Kevin, is $6.5 million, and I had spoke on the floor, but you know the detail is that between the charter school monies that we pay for tuition for children in Duquesne, the money that we pay to East Allegheny and West Mifflin for the high school students, plus the bond issue that we had for the construction and renovation of the Duquesne school building, as well as the mandated education busing costs, those four numbers combined are higher than $6 million. We don't have a nickel to educate a child in Duquesne as this budget stands. We have a responsibility as elected officials to care about every child. Whether they live in my district or they live in Warren County, I should care about kids. I'm trying to get that message to my colleagues. Folks, you cannot open up a school without any money. And if you're going to continue to make a commitment to these children, it has to just be on just books in a classroom. It has to be everything that every affluent school district has. We have to make education equally available to all. And I'm so disappointed to tell you right now, that's not happening.
Well, previously the state had made it a commitment, a promise, to provide an extra $2 million to Duquesne to make sure that school remains open. That's not currently in the proposed budget?
No, it's not in the proposed budget. The $2 million isn't in the proposed budget. The charter school tuition reimbursement is not in this proposed budget. Those monies combined alone are $3.5 million that would keep Duquesne at least to have classrooms, teachers, and extracurricular activities that are just, at the best description, you know, basic and board, you know, the very basic opportunities of some arts and music and, say, sports teams. We're not even there yet. And so their $2 million commitment from this Department of Education and this governor has ceased to exist, although we negotiated that in 06. And I understand it was another administration, but obviously we should all know that education should be our first key component to this state, and educating our kids is our future. So I'm at a loss to know. I wrote a letter, Kevin, to the Secretary of Education, Secretary Tamales. I wrote a letter to Chairman Adolph and Chairman Markosik of the Appropriations Committee. The letter basically said, if the money's not available to Duquesne to fund this school district, if this Board of Control doesn't vote for a budget, mm-hmm. what happens next? We are actually at that point in time. And they didn't give me an answer. The answer was, unbelievably, we've never crossed that threshold for that to happen. So I'm here fighting. I'm here believing in these kids, believing in this community, because they are. They're coming around. They want to succeed. They want to find an opportunity for these children. And, you know, I'm at a loss. And we're here talking about it because it's so important to care about children.
And the decisions right now rest with the State Board of Control on how they're possibly going to come up with the MUF money to try to open up this school. And we're looking at teacher layoffs. We're looking at programs being eliminated, and still may not happen.
Still may not happen. There is not enough money to open up the doors. I don't know how we do it. And let me tell you, if we do find money for Duquesne, beyond the formula that's been set by the standard for the Department of Education, I have a great expectation that every school district in financial distress has the same right to have access to those monies. You can't now just set aside Duquesne as one and not care about Clareton or Jeanette or Stowe Rocks. They're all in the same situation. These kids all deserve an education. What's so regrettable is there are school districts, like West Mifflin is laying off teachers. East Allegheny's done layoffs, and they've held the line on taxes. McKeesport is raising taxes but held the line on laying off teachers. Clareton has done both, layoffs and a small tax increase. My Mon Valley communities are all paying the price for this budget. But there's affluent communities mm-hmm. like Bethel Park and Upper St. Clair that are less than 10 miles away from these kids. They offer a plethora of opportunities in education. Yet we have at Duquesne, and these kids can't even open up a book. I don't even know if they'll have enough money to have books this year. That's what's so distressing to me.
Well, in these budget proposals, it's the lower income school districts that are really feeling the sharpest pain from this proposed budget. You held a town hall where you invited teachers and parents from all over the region to talk about these issues. It was a big deal. Thousands or hundreds of people were there.
It was over 700 people. To have a town hall meeting with 700 people is
enormous.
It's enormous, yes. And great feedback, passion, compassion, and but the statistics. Just Duquesne cuts. The cuts to the children of Duquesne are almost $2,000 per classroom. You couldn't add up all the affluent school districts together. Take seven of the top affluent school districts in Allegheny County. They don't equal $2,000 in cuts in total. This isn't share the pain, as this governor said in his budget address. This is share the pain, poor school districts. We're going to make you fail. And then we don't have an answer for you. Yeah. And then what do? And that's where I'm at. I don't understand. I mean, help everybody get through this. Let's address the demographic needs we have. We understand we're not all, we don't all have $250,000 houses on every lot. But that's what makes Pennsylvania so unique. We have a commitment to every child, not just, and that's to my colleagues, not just to the children in your school district. You have to care about mine too, because eventually they're going to have an outcome for you. And I fight for that every day, and I hope we're changing, hearts and minds about this issue.
Well, let's take a break now and show everyone a little bit of that town hall meeting you held, because it was a town hall meeting that turned into a rally beforehand, and our cameras were there.
We are one! We are one!
Governor Corbett has decided to punish a lot of school districts. We are one of them. We are here to send him a message tonight. No, it's not fair to our children that he make these budget cuts so they can't get the proper education.
Well, you don't cut education, one of the most important things that you can have in a budget, when you definitely have the money to do it.
These kids deserve better, and these kids deserve to take a much closer look at that budget and do what's right for public education.
For a governor to come to my house and tell me that there's been no cuts is amazing to me. Let me tell you something. This school district alone, if this board has to face a $1 million cut, if we did nothing but go back to the basic ed funding cuts from 08-09, there's a $1 million cut in the McKeesport Area School District. It's a lie. He's lying to us, and he's playing games with numbers so he looks good in the news and the press.
A large crowd, a raucous crowd, a passionate crowd, but hopefully there's a few days left where maybe some money can be restored to not only McKeesport, the other school districts, but Duquesne as well.
Yeah, let's hope that everybody gets it finally, that we have a commitment to all children in this state, poor or rich. We want to educate everyone. We have a constitutional obligation to do that, and I stand willing and ready to make those tough votes and help them out.
And we should say the state has $500 million in the bank right now could be put to use to prevent these cuts.
$500 million that would address these cuts would erase those funding deficits that we talk about over and over and over again.
All right. Well, Representative Marc Gergely, thank you for joining us, and all of you for watching. We'll see you next time.